Folks, welcome to Market Technical Analysis by InTheMoneyStocks.com for October 10th, 2007. Well, we're going to get right into it here and talk a little bit about the markets. And we saw another divergence in the markets today with tech leading the way up and the NASDAQ moving up about 7.7 points higher. In addition, we also saw weakness in the transports and the Dow as the Dow closed down 85.84 points or 0.61% on the day and the S&P closed lower by 2.68 points. Again, we saw the transports drop nicely today, down 51 points. And again, what we saw a couple big large cap companies in the Dow come in with negative earnings. And just to mention a couple, we saw Monsanto, MON, is one. In addition, we also saw Valero, and Monsanto ended down a dollar there for those of you that are interested. But Valero actually came out, and this is an interesting one today, folks. We saw Valero coming out and saying that they lowered guidance going forward, things were not as pretty as it seemed, and what does the stock do? It gaps down early, only to recover and go up by 2 points on the day. And this is really the story of today. The dollar continues to weaken here. It started again yesterday after bouncing for a couple days, and it started to weaken again yesterday. And what we saw was a continual weakening in the dollar today, which pushed again, as we all know, and we've said in the past videos, when the dollar weakens, it tends to push up oil and gold. And oil rose by over a dollar today again, and gold rose $2.90 on the day. And this pushed basically all these oil stocks right back up again, and in many ways it kept the markets afloat from having a worse day. At one point today, and I'll bring up the ES chart, this is the ES futures chart, we actually saw the ES trading as low as, here we have it all the way down here, at 1565 and a quarter at the low on the day. And that was after we made a nice little pattern here I'll just talk about in a minute. But again, what we saw was during the middle portions of the day, the market on the negative side, even the NASDAQ on the negative side, but as you see here, starting right about 220-ish or so, right about there, 120 to 130 there, we saw a buy program come in, and basically just what we've been seeing over all the past days with this market being super, super strong, the NASDAQ was able to recover, even the ES and the Dow were able to recover large portions of their decline early. The NASDAQ did close positive, and I'll bring up the NASDAQ chart for us all to take a look at. Here we have it at the lows down here around 1 o'clock-ish, and what did we see here? Just a constant move up all afternoon into the close, closing near the highs on the NASDAQ. And again, the NASDAQ closed up about 7.7 points. And this has been a recurring theme, guys. Technology is the hottest sector. We've been saying this for weeks now, is that technology just wants to go higher and higher. And until we see a fade out of technology, they seem to want to keep this whole market afloat. And again, we did see weakness in the Dow, which is a little interesting, and that could be based off a lot of these earnings misses that we saw in some of these larger cap plays. But very interesting going on in the market. All right, I'm going to look quickly at the daily here, and again, you just see this parabolic move here. And this is key, guys. You can be long or short the market at any point. The key is always to maintain a stop. Figure out what you want to lose and what's a worst-case scenario, and put your stop there and just abide by it. This way, you know, no one's 100% even out there, and that's really keys when it comes to trading the market. In the chat room, anyone in the chat room knows we're not 100% at calling out the calls. We do very well, maybe an 80% percentage ratio right now or whatnot. But as long as we take small losses on one side, then in the long run, we do very, very well. And I'll go into a little of the day trading chat room plays today, which were phenomenal. Again, we caught one that was just unbelievable, threw me for a loop even because it was so good. So again, we'll go into that. But as you can see, this NASDAQ, off this August 16th move, it's been almost parabolic. And at some point, again, you know, as I say, and we were talking about the Dow being the weaker, the Dow and the S&P being the weaker, and we saw that to the effect of that today, as the ES, the Dow, the ES, and the S&P all closed down on the day, while the NASDAQ did close positive. But those have been the ones, the weak ones. And when we do ever, if we ever do, I should say if, because it seems like this market never wants to come down, but should we roll in this market, then we will see probably the Dow and the S&P lead us down, because those have been the weaker indexes. All right, and we saw decent volume today, again on the light side on the ES. Contracts traded was 1.3 million. And again, for an average day where there's no holiday around us, we're in the middle of a week here on a Wednesday, that's pretty light volume, believe it or not. We should be doing 1.5, 2 million, 2.5, somewhere in that range, right around 2 million contracts. So it's a very interesting to note that the volume has been a little on the light side here. And again, oil was up big today. And I attribute a large portion of the market's move up based on the oil move up today. Now let's go into a couple technical patterns here, and I'm going to get out my trend tool here and annotate a little bit. And just a little note here, there's not a lot going on in this chart except for one thing. You obviously had a nice little buy program here, but I just want to point out one thing here. It's a little hard to see, but you guys know head and shoulder patterns. And note this head and shoulder right here. It's a little tough to see because it's a wick right here. It's like a little a tail right there, as you can see. But that's a shoulder there. You have a head right here and another shoulder here. All right, and then watch this. You take the line from the shoulder, draw it right across, all right, in this realm, anywhere in this realm is all right, and you get a breakdown and you get a little move down right down there. And that's a breakdown signal. Now, what we saw pretty much as soon as it broke down and went to the lows there of the day, then that was it. Once it broke that pattern and made that full pattern come to fruition, and you got that move down here, all of a sudden we saw a rally, and we rallied basically all the way up. What I do want to point out, we always talk about topping candles here. And you see this wick right here, and it closing in the lower areas of this candle right here. That's always a dead giveaway that we're ready, we're setting up for another move down. So you continue to watch for those in the market, because you can start to get used to looking at them, and when you do your own technical analysis or your charting or your candlestick patterns, you can always look for these different patterns. And note off that candle what type of move. We did get a nice little move down there off that candle before we bounced off the 200 moving average. And again, this brown line right here is the 200 moving average. That's the most solid of all moving averages. You're always going to get a bounce the first time you come back down to that moving average and touch it. And so we did right into the close, and we bounced up. In addition, just going back here, and let me take a couple of these lines off. Let's take those off here. What you saw here is that we did actually come down here, and look at right here. Notice how this is the 20 moving average, and we could never get above that. And this is pre-market right here, 8 o'clock to 9 o'clock. But it basically held underneath that 20 moving average. And moving averages are so key to learning how to trade and understanding the market. They really abide by those moving averages almost to a T. In addition, what you saw here is you had a move back up here, and the head of the head and shoulders pattern here happened to coincide with the 50 moving average. And it got through a little bit, came right down, and started to move down. And again, right over here, the shoulder happened to coincide right here with the 20 moving average again right there. So I just want to point out here how key these moving averages are just in the intraday analysis that we do. And again, as we saw here, you came down and bounced off the 200 moving average. Now looking at the daily chart here on the ES, and this is the S&P futures, those of you that don't have this can always look at the SPY. The SPY will work just as well. We use the ES future chart, but here's the SPY, and you can see this just parabolic move here. We haven't touched the 20 moving average since all the way back here, and at some point we really do need to touch that. And in this market, it seems like a parabolic move here. We're just continuing to go up, and that might be the case, but at some point we will come down. But at this point, you just can't short the market into this much strength. It's just too strong. You want to wait for the right candle formations on the daily chart to give signals to you that you might fall, whether it's a couple-day breakdown. Really, we put together two consecutive down days. Maybe that's a signal. I don't know if it is, but you know, who knows in this type of market. All right? All right, just going over some day trading stuff today, guys. A couple calls in the market. One we were watching all day was BHIP. And I happened to fall asleep, but a couple in the chat room caught it, and they saw it right away go. And look at this type of move here. And I want to show you the daily chart. Look at this amazing move higher here and how parabolic this was. It just shot right up from basically $2 to $7. Then over the last few days, it kind of came in. Just like it's like a push, pause, push again. We watch for these because when they come back in, at some point they will go again, and today was that day. So congratulations to those in the chat room that caught that. But as you see, look at this move. It basically took off from $4, went all the way to $5.74 before pulling back. In addition, one we brought up today was BHO, and we were able to pick up some shares here at $17. And all of a sudden, what gave us this alert was this large buy block here. 130,000 block went off here, and I said to people in the chat room, guys, we've noticed in the past how when this stuff happens, it's a dead signal they move this stock later on in the day. It's someone big buying, whether it's a hedge fund or a money manager, or who knows, it's a dead signal that the stock will move. And we picked up some shares right around $17. The stock ran later that day to over $20 for just a phenomenal gain. Now, I personally sold on a move through 18, making about $1.15 on it. But other people in the chat room did very well as well, and it was just a phenomenal move. All right, guys, and I'll just again show you a couple odds and ends. We'll go back to the NASDAQ chart to show you that move today and as we finish up today. All right, guys, any questions, you can always email us. We'll do our best to get back to you. But other than that, come join the chat room. Come join the Swing Trade Alerts. We're always here to be of service, obviously, when you subscribe. And the other thing I'd like to say is just always keep in mind, always talk to your financial advisors. This is our opinion, purely our opinion. For real investment advice, go to your financial advisors for real advice. We'll talk to you soon. Take care.